Italy is pushing ahead with the most ambitious bridge ever attempted, a 3.6-kilometer span across the Strait of Messina that would become the longest suspension bridge in the world. Supporters call it a miracle of engineering, but behind the promise of faster travel and thousands of jobs lie fears of earthquakes, mafia corruption, and billion-euro risks. In this video, we'll uncover what's really at stake, and why this bridge could become either Italy's proudest achievement or its biggest disaster. Before we cross into the details of the Strait of Messina Bridge, connect to Design Zip by subscribing for more mega projects and engineering marvels from around the world. Before we tell you about the chaos surrounding the Strait of Messina Bridge, let's talk about what Italy is actually trying to build here, because this is not some regular construction project. If it goes ahead, it will be the longest suspension bridge in the world. The entire structure will stretch about 3.6 kilometers, linking Sicily with Calabria across the Strait of Messina. To put that in perspective, this span is nearly double the length of Japan's Akashi Kaikyo Bridge, which currently holds the record. Italy had this idea sitting in dusty government files since the 1960s, so now this bridge is like this country's shot at global prestige. And the design is not small on ambition either. The bridge will be 60 meters wide. This would be enough to handle 6 lanes of road traffic plus 2 railway tracks. The daily capacity numbers promised here are insane. Promoters claim it could carry 6,000 vehicles per hour and 200 trains a day, figures designed to impress, if not entirely realistic. Supporters are pitching this as the ultimate cure for Sicily's isolation, a structure that finally kills the need for those slow ferries. Today, if you want to cross, you have to take a 20-minute ferry ride, plus there are many delays, queues, and bad weather cancellations. The bridge would make that crossing seamless. It will cut the travel time down to a few minutes. Italy's government is not shy about hyping this up either. Prime Minister Giorgia Meloni calls it an engineering marvel of global significance. Her Transport Minister, Matteo Salvini, has gone even further, calling it the biggest infrastructure project in the West. When politicians start talking like this, you know the stakes are high. And they have put real money behind the hype. The price tag of this project is about 13 billion euros. The money has already been allocated in national budgets stretching through the next decade. Some think the huge price tag is justified since they have promised that the project is going to last centuries. WeBuild is the lead company here, and it has claimed that the structure could stand strong for 200 years with the right maintenance. That's the kind of bold statement construction firms love making, but if it proves true, this bridge will outlive several generations of Italians. And beyond the raw engineering, the economic promises are huge. Supporters claim the project will generate up to 120,000 jobs every year during construction. This number is being used to sell the idea to unions, local governments, and pretty much anyone who needs a paycheck in southern Italy. Billions will also flow into supporting projects like new train stations, upgraded roads, coastal reinforcement, and even reforestation. For Sicily and Calabria, which are the regions often ignored in favour of northern Italy's booming cities, this looks like a once-in-a-lifetime investment. Even the companies involved give the project a global edge. The consortium behind the bridge includes WeBuild from Italy, Satir from Spain, and IHI from Japan. These firms have built mega projects like the Panama Canal expansion, Japan's Akashi Suspension Bridge, and Turkey's Osman Gazi Bridge. In other words, it's a high-profile international partnership. Which makes sense. If Italy wants to claim a world record, it has to bring out the best. Another great thing is that the bridge is designed not just for convenience, but to survive where it stands. And the Strait of Messina is no calm setting. The Strait of Messina is one of the most dangerous stretches of water in Europe. That's why this engineering marvel comes with a long list of issues that cannot be swept aside with a press conference. Let's start with the most obvious: earthquakes. Messina is in one of the most violent seismic zones on the continent. The 1908 earthquake flattened the city and killed tens of thousands of people. Engineers say the bridge could survive a magnitude 7.5 quake. But earthquakes don't follow design manuals, and that bold claim may be tested in ways no model can predict. a tremor of that size hitting directly under the strait could challenge even the most advanced designs. And if the bridge ever fails during a quake, it will be a financial disaster and a national humiliation. Then there is the wind problem. The Strait of Messina acts like a wind tunnel. Gusts rip through the channel unpredictably, and the longer and taller the bridge, the more it catches those forces. The builders claim the deck can withstand winds up to 181 miles per hour. For comparison, that's hurricane-level strength, twice as high as anything ever recorded in the strait. It's impressive, but also suspicious. Long suspension bridges are especially vulnerable to oscillation. Even a steady crosswind can cause swaying and vibrations. Engineers say they have planned for it, but wind fatigue is not something you solve once. It is a lifetime headache. Another silent enemy is corrosion. Salt water is brutal, and the Strait of Messina is all salt spray, all the time. Steel cables, towers, joints, and bearings are constantly exposed to salty air, humidity, and high heat in summer. Even with modern coatings and reinforced materials, salt corrosion will begin immediately, meaning maintenance teams will be busy from day one, monitoring every inch of steel constantly, and that means billions more in upkeep across decades. Anyone who thinks this is a one-time payment of 13 billion euros is dreaming. And let's not forget structural fatigue. A bridge carrying 6,000 vehicles per hour plus 200 trains every single day is under relentless stress. Trains, especially heavy freight, don't glide gently, they pound. Over decades, that constant pounding takes a toll on joints, decks, and cables. Expansion joints will wear, bearings will need replacing, and the whole system will demand upgrades long before that promised 200-year lifespan. Even temperature changes pose a threat. A span of 3.6 kilometers will expand and contract dramatically between scorching Sicilian summers and cold winters. That means stress on the cables, the towers, and the connections to the land. Designers can build in flexibility, but over time, metal fatigue is inevitable. If these problems were not enough, locals are not the only ones protesting against its construction. The No Ponte movement has grown into one of the loudest voices in Sicily and Calabria. There are banners, marches, and petitions everywhere claiming that they don't want the Strait of Messina Bridge. And it's not just activists, it's lawyers, homeowners, and everyday people who see this project as a disaster waiting to happen. The property issue is personal. More than 400 homes will be expropriated, and some estimates say it could push closer to 1,000. Some residents have gone public, saying even triple the value of their house wouldn't convince them to move. Environmental groups are just as fierce. They have filed complaints with the EU, warning that the bridge would destroy wetlands, disrupt migratory bird routes, and damage ecosystems that have existed for thousands of years. Local lawyers say the Torre Faro district, with its ponds and nature reserve, should be protected, not paved over. And they are threatening years of appeals in European courts to block it. Some supporters argue Sicily has been isolated too long, and only a direct link will bring in new jobs, tourists, and investment. They point to Denmark's Great Belt Bridge or Greece's Rio Anterio Bridge as proof that massive projects can transform whole regions. Critics, however, say it's a bridge to nowhere. It will connect two of Italy's poorest regions without fixing their deeper problems. Not only that, but many locals are worried about the corruption. They believe the 'Ndrangheta and Cosa Nostra will inevitably find ways into billion euro contracts, no matter what safeguards the government promises. If the mafia can control ferry services today, why wouldn't they jump on the biggest infrastructure deal in southern Italy's history? And then there is the politics. Many Sicilians and Calabrians say the bridge is not helping them at all, and that it's just a flashy headline for Rome, while the south is still stuck with broken roads, old hospitals, and underfunded schools. What makes people even more suspicious is the NATO angle of this story. Italy has to spend a big slice of its budget on defence. Some politicians want the bridge counted as part of that spending, since Sicily is strategic and in theory the bridge could move troops and equipment. Supporters say it's smart planning. Locals say it's just a trick to hide the true cost. The Strait of Messina Bridge promises record-breaking engineering, faster connections, and thousands of jobs, but it also carries the weight of earthquakes, corruption fears, and deep local resistance. Personally, I think it's one of those projects where ambition may be outpacing reality, and Italy risks trading long-term stability for short-term prestige. But what about you? Do you think this bridge will transform southern Italy for the better, or is it destined to become a billion-euro mistake? Share your thoughts in the comments. I'd love to hear where you stand. And if you enjoyed this breakdown, subscribe to Design Zip for more stories on the world's boldest architecture, mega projects, and construction challenges. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.